On to hunting usernames and accounts. Now, this is pretty straightforward, but I want to show you some different tools that we can utilize that are web-based and just kind of get your wheels spinning on what you should be doing and what you should be looking for when you are hunting usernames and accounts. Now, there are also tools that are great in terms of being able to use on Linux, and we'll cover those later in the course. But for now, we'll stick with the website-based tools. Now, when we talk about hunting usernames, let's say that we have somehow identified a username, or maybe that's all we're given. Sometimes when we have an investigation, say somebody's harassing somebody else, just as an example, all we have is a username in that person. And perhaps we could take that username and try to find if it's been used anywhere else, and then start chaining our information together. So that's kind of what we're going to look for now, is how can we start hunting down usernames and tying them to other accounts, or how can we tie them to other profiles? So you can do this on your own, by the way. I think this is a good trial run to just see if you have any accounts out there for any of these profiles that maybe you forgot about and you want to delete, etc. But what I'm going to show you is this website here called Namecheck. Now, these first three websites all do the same thing. What's going on this website, and I'll put this in the resources, by the way, and it's namecheck.com. What it's doing is it's actually seeing what usernames are available. So if you search for a username and it's not available, then it will show you that it's not available. So it's trying to help you find accounts for these websites. So what we can do is we can come in here and just say, like, the Cyber Mentor. And we search, and it'll say, hey, what's available? So the cybermentor.com, not available. I have that as a website, so that makes sense. But any of these other websites are available. But when we come down to usernames, there is no YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, Reddit, or Pinterest, or Medium, or Keybase. That's interesting. I don't even, if there's a Cyber Mentor Pinterest, this is news to me. Let's go ahead and check it out and see what's there. And it just says something went wrong. So this could be a false positive right here. But this tells you kind of where I might have accounts and where I don't have accounts. And then this one says there's too many redirects, so we don't know for sure. But all these other places, I don't have accounts. So what you're doing is you're trying to see, okay, where does this user have an account? This user has an account on YouTube. I'm going to check out this YouTube account. And now you found me right here, right? So there's my YouTube, and here's my Twitter, and here's my Twitch. And so say you actually had a user that you were doing research on or a username, you could start tying these different accounts here. And that's all that these websites really do, is you're just looking to see if you can tie them in. Now, Pastebin, Trip, I don't know what Trip is, Hacker News, some of these stuff I don't even know. So sometimes these could be false positives, but there's useful information here in terms of Telegram, potentially Pastebin, although Pastebin's kind of been really restricted as of late. And then you can come in here to these other websites too. And just because one says one thing, you might want to check other websites and just see. Now, this will look up X-rated materials as well, so just be careful when you're searching for this stuff. You can do the alt exclude, which is the default. When I show you later with Recon NG how to do this, this will actually include the X-rated stuff as well. So just make sure that you're cognizant and aware and etc. But X-rated is good depending on the investigation you're doing. If you're trying to find say like a child predator or something, and maybe they're on X-rated websites, or somebody that's, you know, involved in that kind of stuff that you might be hunting down. It doesn't hurt to try to find usernames in bad places too, because sometimes that's where you might have to look. But here you can see again, Keybase, Spotify, Medium, Twitch, Telegram, Patreon, the Internet Archive, Reddit, and Twitter. So you can come through here. It also has the category link. You can dump this out to Excel or CSV or PDF. So this is really nice. And it just kind of tells you, you know, what you've got out here. Last one, namecheckup.com, same thing. I'm not going to run this again. Now, what I do want to show you are a couple of other neat tricks that I've found in the past. One is that if you're looking for other accounts, maybe accounts that just don't show up here, and I'm thinking mobile apps, okay? So I'm not going to get on mobile and show you, but start thinking of the mobile apps that you might use, like a TikTok or a Kick or Snapchat or Telegram, which was on this name checker. And what things that you might be able to see from this. So I just typed in random names here. I went to kick.me and /mav because I tried typing in Maverick to see. Now, this came up as a user of Virginia Thompson. say we had a username of Mav that we were searching, but maybe say it's like Mav something unique, like 123725, I don't know. And that tied back to this person. Now we have a confirmed, hey, here's a name that ties to this account. Maybe at this point we didn't have a name at all. So this could be a potential tie to a name. Even better, what happens sometimes is you're searching, say something like Kick, and you have somebody like this where the name is Heat. This one says Add Lux Hustler, but here you can see that there's an image, and the really nice thing is you can right click and you can open this image in a new tab. And guess what? You see that little crop? You get the whole image. Now, what can you do with this image? You could save this image. You can try to go and, you know, see if you can find this on a reverse image search. This in particular looks like it has to deal with Michael Jordan, and you could see the Space Jam Michael Jordan, the Chicago Bulls Michael Jordan. So this is interesting as well, but doesn't really have any ties to anything right here. But the nice idea is what you could see is you can right click, view the image, actually go back and then start working with this image as well if you can find that. Same thing with Snapchat. A lot of these companies have username enumeration. So if there is a particular email or a particular username you want to try and see if you can find if that account exists, you can come in here, just type it in, and then try logging in. So I just came in and typed in the Cyber Mentor, and I went and just typed this, hit log in. You can see it says cannot find the user. Now, if you try something else, I'm going to try, I saw Adele. I'm just going to see if that works. I'm trying something just common that would perhaps work. This one says cannot find the user either. So if you had a working username, it should work here where it says, hey, this is a valid user. Same thing with the email. And then the other thing that you can do, and this happens on a lot of applications, is you can come in, and this is just a picture I grabbed, but this, if you've ever used Snapchat, if you slowly type in the username, you perhaps can see possible usernames. See how they're typing in Adele, and you see Adele, but they also see this Adelaide Crows. You have options here where maybe you see this, but like if you're hunting a specific username, the other thing that you might see is you might have this username down here, but then you have a full name. Just like the Kick, right? Like the Virginia Thompson, somebody might have their full name in here when you type in that username. And then again, you just have more information disclosed to you. So that's what you're looking up here. I'll provide all these references down below, but what I want you to be thinking about is doing these name checks, finding out where a username could exist or does exist and correlating those to other accounts, digging in and seeing like Reddit's a great one. Like if I go to Reddit, what post history do I have for this user? What do they have? You see, I'm posting all about my YouTube here. But like you could see different sorts of things that I posted. Maybe I have a Reddit history that discloses information about me or something along those lines, right? Like this is the stuff that you could start tying in more and more and more information and verifying, you know, that it belongs to that person as well. But once you have that in mind as well, think about things that aren't on this list, perhaps like Skype, Kick, Snapchat, Telegram, TikTok. Think about all the different types of apps where you might be able to type in a name or an email address or something and then correlate that back. So get your wheel spinning, start thinking, thinking like an investigator, thinking outside the box, and just try, just don't rely on tools as well, rely on manual methodology is the point I'm trying to get at. So that is it for this lesson and this section, and I will look forward to seeing you in the next section.